To begin Igor Shesterkin's career simulation at 25 years old, he's looking to help the Rangers win their fifth Stanley Cup. Igor probably could perform better this season as he finished with a 914 save percentage and a 271 goals against while picking up 32 wins. However, Shesterkin's numbers won't be good enough. The Rangers are finishing with a 43-30-9 record and they're missing the playoffs. Heading into this season, everyone's expecting more. New York's hoping to make it back to the playoffs, while Shesterkin, he's hoping to bounce back. Sadly, none of those things are happening. Igor was mid this season, winning 32 games while posting a 909 save percentage and a 287 goals against. And the Rangers weren't much better either. They had a record of 43-34-5, and they're missing the playoffs for the second year in a row. Igor, you've had back-to-back seasons where you've underperformed. If we want this team to get back in the playoff picture, I'm going to need more from you. Also, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe. I'm trying to hit 4,000 subs by the end of the year, and every single sub helps a ton. And drop a like, I want to see if we can get 500 likes on this video. So Shesterkin ignored exactly what I said and put up almost identical numbers. He posted a 907 save percentage and a 285 goals against. I'm also ignoring the fact he played 5 additional games and only won one more compared to last season. With Shesterkin in net, we had a record of 33-31-4. In order to finish with a record of 44-34-4, our backup had a record of 11-3. I'm starting to think we had the wrong goalie playing for us. In the first round, the Rangers would be matched up against the eventual Stanley Cup champion New Jersey Devils, and we went down bad. Bro, you were terrible. What are those numbers? After our backup goalie carried us last season, we let him walk and brought Matt Murray in to replace him. All I'm saying is if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Out of nowhere, Shesterkin's playing to my expectations. He's posting a 913 save percentage and a 269 goals against while picking up 31 wins. Keep in mind, he only won 2 less games compared to last season, but played 15 less games. And with a record of 45-29-8, the New York Rangers and Shesterkin are looking to bounce back from their embarrassing playoff performance last season. The Rangers would perform better, but it wasn't enough as they would lose to the eventual Stanley Cup champion Philadelphia Flyers in the first round. In the offseason, Igor Shesterkin was looking for a change of scenery and he's leaving the Rangers to join the Carolina Hurricanes. And the goaltender situation is looking amazing here. Not only do we have Shesterkin starting for us, but our backup is Tuukka Rask. I have high expectations for this team. You better not let me down. No cap, I don't know what happened. Shesterkin was terrible, posting a 900 save percentage and a 319 goals against. And it should be no surprise that this team's also sucking with a 33-35-14 record and they're missing the playoffs. I'm going to assume last season was a fluke. There's no way this team could be this bad, right? It was a slightly better year for Shesterkin. He had numbers of a 905 save percentage and a 303 goals against while picking up 26 wins. But with a 35-40-7 record, the Hurricanes are missing the playoffs for the second year in a row. Alright, no more messing around. We have a good team here and what I think should be a good goalie. At the bare minimum, this team should be making the playoffs. Shesterkin was better this season, but the bar was so low it was almost impossible for him to do worse. He's posting a 909 save percentage and a 299 goals against. And who would have thought with a 36-34-12 record, this team sucks and they're missing the playoffs. Remember when I said this? I have high expectations for this team. You better not let me down. It was a much simpler time. Igor's numbers are slowly getting better with a 919 save percentage and a 270 goals against. But with his success came this team's failure as they somehow did worse with a 34-37-11 record. How is it possible for this team to do worse when their goalie did better? I've reached the point where I wouldn't mind getting swept in the first round. At least if we get swept, that means we made the playoffs. Shesterkin's finishing with very similar numbers compared to last season, with a 912 save percentage and a 281 goals against. And with a record of 42-34-6, the Rangers are missing the playoffs by 1 point. One single point. Not gonna lie, that one hurts. I don't care what you do anymore. Do whatever you have to in order to make the playoffs. When I said do whatever you have to, I didn't expect this. Igor Shesterkin's traded from the Carolina Hurricanes to the Dallas Stars. And we're going to ignore the fact that he was absolutely terrible this season. But just because Shesterkin isn't in Carolina anymore, that doesn't change anything. Dallas is terrible as well, and they're missing the playoffs with a 38-35-9 record. In free agency, the New York duo is back together, but they're in Nashville this time. But the last time this duo was together, nothing good happened. So why would I expect anything different this time? Igor's time in Nashville ended pretty quick, with him being traded to the Edmonton Oilers to become their backup. And this was the best case scenario, because the Oilers are finishing second in the league with a 53-25-4 record. I don't care if Igor's the backup. If he can get a Stanley Cup, then it's all worth it. That's it. I'm done. This was possibly the worst career simulation of all time. If you hated this video like I did, go check this one out on screen. It's much better than this one. And if you haven't already, drop a like and subscribe.